Love the camera work in that. Just love it.
The temple must have been built around this.
Around what?
A statue. A gold statue.
A huge gold statue. And look here. These people, they're worshipping the damn thing. At least, I think they're people.
I think they're people.
El Dorado, the Golden Man. Sully, it wasn't a city of gold. It was this. It was a golden idol.
Man, can you imagine what that thing would be worth now?
Look over here. Tracks.
I bet the Spanish dragged it out on cut logs.
We're 400 years late for this party.
So the trail's cold.
Yeah, it looks that way.
Son of a bitch.
Unless.
Unless what?
We follow the tracks.
Dun dun dun. Anyway, also important thing to do is after a cutscene like this, once you enter into a new area, it's good to explore a bit, because there might be treasure involved. And I believe there's, I know there's a treasure right here in this area. Just can't remember where exactly it was. We were talking right here, so straight backwards. I know there's a treasure. Maybe not here per se. Wait, what's here? Nothing's here. Nothing's here. Oh, right here. Sparkling treasure. That's 5 treasures. And every 5 treasures, you get a medal. Not that it matters, of course, because I actually have all the medals. You know, it's amazing concept that the El Dorado is a golden man, golden statue. But they're kind of dumb in thinking that, well, if they find a treasure, how the hell are they going to get it out of here? You know, it's huge. And we come to the jungle,
they stop here.
Where the tracks are no more.
Spaniards must have made themselves a shortcut to get the treasure out.
It's always good to, fun to platform when you can. Not only because it's fun, but because it can be rewarding. Such as the treasure right here. Okay. Still no combat yet, which is a good thing, kind of, in a way. Because in crushing difficulty, I know I'm going to die a lot. And it's going to be kind of embarrassing to show that, but... And again, I did want to kind of showcase how hard this game can be in crushing difficulty. Because you're shot like twice, and your entire screen goes black and white. And you can't really do anything, because one more shot and you're dead.
There's something you don't see every day.
My God.
Again, this game storytelling has a lot of inspiration from like Indiana Jones and stuff of that nature. So, oh crap, what the hell? I've never done that before in my entire experience with this game. That was ridiculous. Sorry about that, guys. But, yeah, the German U-boat in the middle of a jungle. You know, it's kind of that mystical, there's a historical kind of aspect to it too. That this game kind of invokes. Just think of Indiana Jones in video game form. And that's pretty much Uncharted. Both games, really. Although the second game has a different inspirational source, probably more inspirational source.
Well, be damned!
Must have come up the river during flood season and gotten stuck. Let's check it out, huh?
Wait! Something about this feels kind of hinky.
Hinky. You act like you've never seen a German U-boat in the middle of the jungle before.
I'm being serious, Nate.
I tell you what, why don't you stay here? I'll check it out myself. I'll call you if I run into any Nazis.
Yeah, right. You do that.
Wait. Hold on to this for me, will ya? Okay. Looks like I'm gonna have to do this the hard way.
Alright, so point is to get into the U-boat. But of course, like a video game should be, it's not as easy as that, just going into a U-boat and just climbing. It involves exploring the jungle. Just love this. I just love this. You know, I think there's been a point now where water in video games has gotten so good. Many attribute to BioShock. But maybe, I don't know. I can't really think of anything before BioShock, I guess, that had incredible water that started affecting every other game. But Uncharted, I think, was one of the beginning pioneers of that too, kind of, as far as water goes. I mean, there was Super Mario Sunshine, which was incredible. So, definitely, I think the technology behind like graphics is improving really a lot. And I never really complain about graphics anymore, except for graphical issues, I guess, that happen. Glitches or pop-ins. Pop-ins really don't bother me that much. Go up the vine here, and there's a treasure. This one's easy to miss, because in platforming, there's this momentum I get. You know, momentum as you just want to keep on playing. I mean, keep on going forward as fast as possible. So it's good to take your time with this game. Take your time, enjoy the sights, enjoy the graphics, just have fun. That's what this game's all about, you know?
Hey, watch yourself up there. It's a long way down.
It is a long way down. An average person wouldn't be doing this, because be like, actually, I'm climbing up stuff. How do I get to that German U-boat from here? I mean, that's what I'd be thinking. But not Drake. Drake kind of goes beyond common sense. He's the adventurous type. He will go into any situation and hope that he'll come out in the end, you know. Hope he'll come out. And he usually does, actually, which is the surprising thing. Actually, I can just drop from here, and it'd be okay because it's water, but I'll follow the designated path.
Hey, you should be able to drop right down into the U-boat from there.
There we go. I'm on the U-boat. Before going in, though, always good to explore more of the area. Look at the sunlight, too. It's incredible. Oh, wait, don't go yet, don't go. No, damn it. At the very end of the U-boat, there's a treasure. It's not letting me go up, which is, crap. But there is treasure up there, if it let me up there.
Okay, I'm in.
What do you see?
Something nasty happened to these guys. There's blood everywhere. And soup.
What?
I think he was joking about the soup there. It's a good time to end the video right here, because right after this is another cutscene.